President Uhuru Kenyatta has no shortage of advisers. In fact, his office has three legal advisers whose input informs the president's decisions. They are the Attorney General, Professor Githu, Solicitor General Njee Muturi, and his personal advisor on constitutional matters, Abdikadir Mohammed. AG Githu is the official legal advisor of government who is tasked with giving the government the correct interpretation of law as well as safeguarding the interests of the public. Solicitor General Njee Muturi is more like the AG's deputy who drafts government proposals and represents the interest of the government in courts and international jurisdictions. He is equally an advisor of government. Abdikadir Mohammed is even closer to the president. His role is to advise the president on constitutional matters and ensuring compliance with the law by the president. Focus has now shifted to the three officers with questions raised on whether they failed to properly advise the president on matters that could have serious legal ramifications. The Law Society of Kenya, in a statement, described the Attorney General as an officer who has failed to perform at the expected level. But Professor Githu has been quick to defend himself, saying that he was not consulted particularly on the matters touching on Justice Tunoi.
The questions that you ask legitimately can be raised with the office of the president. What has been received, when it was received, what is contained, what is missing, etc., etc. The office of the Attorney General advises, where the advice is sought, on whether in the totality of the circumstances there exists material to proceed with further action.
So who among the three advised the president on the decision not to form the tribunal? Could the president have ignored the advice from any of the three officers? Or is it just a case of people sleeping on their jobs?
The Attorney General himself has been rendered like a castrated bull. Nobody hears what he does. Nobody knows what he does. Nobody knows whether he's listened to.
This is not the first time President Kenyatta has been accused of violating the law. Last year, civil society groups and the opposition coalition moved to court to challenge the Security Laws Amendment Act, which the president signed into law despite an uproar over its unconstitutionality. The president also came under fire after endorsing an amendment to the Judicial Service Commission Act, which gave the president more say in the appointment of the Chief Justice.
The continuing interference with the Judicial Service Commission, including bringing a law to parliament that is under challenge in court, to arrogate himself the authority to appoint the Chief Justice and other judges. The office of the Auditor General is, as you know, under threat. Court is in court on this.
With this, President Kenyatta's critics think that the president has mutilated the constitution, but many would shy away from impeaching him, citing political reasons. Ken Dagor, Obadiah, for the Big Question.